الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيئنا وطبيب قلوبنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم أرسله الله تعالى بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المذنب الخاطئ بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى قد أمرنا في كتابه العزيز وقال عز وجل من قائل أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الحبيب الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Beloved brothers and sisters, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He deserves to be praised. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the gifts, for all the bounties that He has shared with us from time to time. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having granted us the opportunity to assemble here this afternoon to glorify Him and to praise Him. We testify that Allah is one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no associate nor partners. And I further testify that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and final prophet who Allah has sent into this world to teach mankind a better way of life. Ashhadu annahu qad ballagha ar-risala. I testify openly in front of all of you here today that he has really delivered the message. Indeed, he has transmitted this message, the risala, to each and every one of us. وَأَدَّى الْأَمَانَةَ And he has transferred that trust, that amana that was given to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has indeed delivered that to us. وَجَاهَدَ أَحْسَنَ الْجِهَادَ And he has fought the best way to protect us from getting close to the hellfire. أَمَّا بَعْدَ Beloved brothers and sisters, I remind my own sinful soul here today, openly in front of you. As I remind you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has lifted the barriers and He has lifted the veil between us and Him. And He speaks to us directly. And He commands us in Holy Quran by saying, O you who believe, O people of faith, O people who have surrendered yourself to Allah, O one who have accepted the oneness of Allah, O the one who have accepted the finality of Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, let not the angel of death come to you. Do not allow yourself to live in a state of lost, in a state of dalala, of going astray. Let not the angel has been sent to you save and except that you have surrendered yourself, Save and accept that you have surrendered yourself to the commands of Almighty Allah. Amma ba'd, my esteemed brothers and sisters, the time has now come that we need to understand our mission and our role in this life. What is the real purpose of me here in this planet? The purpose of each and every one of us, it is nothing but obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is accepting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the Rabb, the creator, the cherisher, the sustainer, the master. If I am under the control of my master, the one who supervises me, the one who gives to me, I have to obey him and all that he commands and requests of me. Here it is. Allah is the Rabb. He is the supreme controller. He is the supreme evolver. He is the one who gives to us. He is the one who grants unto us, and he takes it. Our existence in this planet depends upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and everything that he has given unto us. But he has sent unto us a prophet, a Nabi, a guide. He did not create us and leave us to wander. It's like any instrument that we have. This recording machine that is in front of us, it comes with a manual. It comes with a book of instruction. How do we know how to use this appliance and to get the best of it? It is to follow the code of instruction that the manufacturer has put into place. We have to read that first. We have to understand what is to be done with this. What is the usage of this? And then when we apply the theory, then we will get the best reality of this product. Allah has created us. So we belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We did not come into this world by chance. It was through the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we were born into this world through our mothers and fathers. And he has sent a book of guidance, a book of instructions, a code, a constitution, a manual that each and every one of us needs to understand properly. Now, he did not send the Quran only by itself through Jibreel, and it's in front of us. But he sent the Quran with an instructor. He sent the Quran with someone who has came into this world and lived it, so we can see how it is in practical, the practical reality of this Quran. And that is why when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he took leave from this world, the companions went to his wife and they said, "Ya Aisha, O mother of the believers, O mother of the faithful, tell us something about the life of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Teach us." She was the teacher of the time after the dismissal of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. She said, "Kana khuluquhu al-Qur'an." His entire conduct, his entire lifestyle was that in conformity with Al-Qur'an. He did not do anything except that it was taken from the Qur'an. So he was called a walking Qur'an. He was called a walking Qur'an. In that you can see the reflection of the instructions of Allah being reflected in his habits, in his personality, in his actions, in his transactions, in every single thing that he has done. It gives us now the opportunity to understand who is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Who is this prophet? Nabiur Rahman, the prophet of mercy. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, "Wama arsalnaka," he begins by saying that I have not sent Muhammad. entire universe. Now Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam was not sent only to mankind or to Muslims. He was not the one who was sent only to Muslims. He was sent to every single creature. He was sent to comfort every single creature. All the creation, all the makhlukat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That he, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in dealing with animals, he executed mercy. He was very gentle. He shared love with the creatures. Even with the plants, with the trees. Even the trees answered to his dua, his calling. Even the tree answered to his da'wah. The animals, the unseen. He, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never took revenge. He never took revenge when anyone has wronged him. He did not say an eye for an eye, an eye for an eye. When he was invited to the city of Taif, and he was called here for them to accept his the prophecy, they rejected him. They shed his blood. That his entire body, blood flew from every pores of his body. That Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and said, Ya Rasulullah, if you should give me permission, I will end this entire city. I will end the entire city. He said, La. He said, we were not sent to take revenge. We did not come here to take revenge on these people. We were sent to comfort them with mercy. We were sent to share glad tidings with them. To let them know that there is hopes. And hence the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, out of this same generation will come great Muslims. Today, alhamdulillah, the entire Taif is Muslim. Ayyuha al-Ahbab, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was the one who has shared tolerance. He was very tolerant. One day he was in the masjid, in Masjid Nabawi, in his mosque. Fadakhal alayhi, and a desert Arab, Bedouin, a desert Arab. And the desert Arab are people who do not have culture in them. They're the ones who live in the Arab, in the desert. Fadakhal al-Masjid. The guy came in and he released himself. He urinated in the masjid. Now, if you were to see this, if someone was to come through that door and he was to go and stand in the corner and urinate in the masjid, what would you? Anyone here? You would first thing get up and get him out and maybe kill him on the spot. But he, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he turned to his companion, to the companion, said, Da'ahu, leave him. Do not interrupt the guy. Leave the guy. Let him release himself. He know what hardship he would have instituted on that person, even if he was to tell the person to stop. Perhaps the guy could have fallen sick immediately. The guy needed to release himself. So he said to his companions, go and bring a container of water and wash the entire area to purify. This was the tolerance of the Prophet that he made the man feel comfortable, and he consoled his companions how to act and how they should treat people because of their intelligence. This man was from the desert. This man was not accustomed to civilization. This man was not accustomed to the norms in a society. So he dealt with that person to his level. Islam, my brothers and sisters, is not about a way of life. It is to build a society and a community for each and every one of us to understand our role and responsibility to play. A father has his role to play in his home. As the head of the household, he is responsible for himself and his children to make sure that everyone is acting within their limits and responsibility. He grooms his children, he prepares his children by showing example in the home. The father and mother, they are the biggest of teachers. They are the first teacher of any child. So they deliver to their children what is called adab, or etiquettes. They will teach their children. The children see etiquettes from as a mirror reflected from the parents. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, when he was speaking to his companions one day, he said, "Innama buist li'utammim makarim al-akhlaq." I was not sent except that I was sent to teach mankind, to teach humankind makarim al-akhlaq, good character. Islam is to build a character. It is to build good moral conduct. It is to teach our children from an infancy stage how to respect elders, how to speak truth, how to treat everyone with love. And this is why the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said to us that Islam is all about what? Good behavior and pattern. That even the smile on your face for your brother and sister, it is nothing but charity. Smile with people. It doesn't take anything from you. Does it cost anything to smile and to show love to everyone? Muslims and non-Muslims, we must cross this barrier. Islam is not a cult that is being practiced, but Islam is a way of life that includes everyone. When our forefathers went to Indonesia, the Arabs, the early Arabs, when they went to Indonesia, they did not speak Java. They did not speak Mahasa, the language or the dialects of those country of that country. They did not speak the language of those people. But what? Their dealings and business, the way they conducted their affairs, they came there as businessmen and as traders. Their truthfulness in their business conduct, the way they live among the people, influenced those people that Indonesia today stands as the largest Muslim country in the world. Every single one of those people became Muslim because of the actions of those who came to them as business or traders. Ayyuhal Ahbab, we can make the same difference here in this country that we live in, in this society that we live in. We need to share and we need to care for everyone. We need to show our concern with our neighbors, with our fellow citizens, with our brothers and sisters, irrespective of their religion, irrespective of their status, irrespective of their color, irrespective of their language. Here we are to profess, "I am a Muslim first and last." May Allah help us and bless us. May Allah show us right as right and help us to follow that which is right. May Allah show us evil as evil and help us to stay far from that which is evil. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى جواد قديم ملك برؤ رؤوف رحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي فضل سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيئنا ومولانا محمد فضله على العالمين جميعا وقامه يوم القيامة المذنبين الخطائين الهالكين شفيعا فصلوات الله وسلام عليه من كل من هو محبوب لديه صلاة تبقى بدوام الملك الحي القيوم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد arsalallahu ta'ala bil haqqi bashiran wa nadhira wa da'iyan ila Allahi bi iznihi wa sirajan munira. Amma ba'd, faqad qala Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala mukhbiran wa amira, inna Allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Wa 'an an-nabi sallallahu 'alayhi wa sallam qala fi hadith sahih, man salla 'alayya marratan wahidatan sallallahu ta'ala 'alayhi biha 'ashra. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Warli Allahumma ala khulafai ar-rashidin, ala Abi Bakr as-Siddiq wa ala Umar bin Khattab wa ala Uthman bin Affan wa ala Ali bin Abi Talib ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi ajma'in. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal muslimin. Allahumma ansur al-mujahideen fi kulli makan. Allahumma alif bayn qulub al-muslimin. Allahumma ihdi shabab al-islam wal-muslimin. Wa salli Allahumma ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Ibadullah, rahimana wa rahimakumullah. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجيب لكم ورزق الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأزو وأجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر.
Allah.